Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 50 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show, selected especially for public television.
Imel here at the Veterans Memorial Museum in Branson, Missouri, where you can see this dramatic sculpture called 50 Soldiers Storming a Beach by Fred Hoppe Jr. of Lincoln, Nebraska. His father, Fred Hoppe Sr., leads the charge. Each of the 50 soldiers is portrayed with the face of an actual World War II combat soldier, one from each state. This show is a special tribute to all the men and women in service to our country as we get ready to celebrate Armed Forces Day and Memorial Day. You know, after all the years of producing the show, we discovered that if every song followed the same theme, sometimes things could get a little dull. So we mixed things up in this show. We have a military theme along with sort of a country music theme, and I think you're really going to enjoy it.
And good evening to you all. Today's Armed Forces Day, and part of our show is a salute to our servicemen. Let's get the show underway.
How you gonna keep them down on the farm after they seem carried? How you gonna keep them away from
those kids have? Well, it's just as much fun for me to be around them. Here's a very pretty song from the musical show Carousel, and our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer, to sing it for you.
All I'd want you to know
Isn't that nice? Norma Zimmer, we call on the band now for a new treatment of a well-known melody, one of my favorite Richard Maltby arrangements, and a fine example of the big band sound. Gentlemen.
Wasn't Lawrence having a great time? He loved to lead that band and dance with all those pretty girls on the show. He was pretty good at it, too. I met Lawrence when I was in the Navy. I entered the All-Navy Talent Contest twice and won it both times, which meant an appearance on the All-Navy Ed Sullivan Show 2 years in a row. The first time I appeared for Lawrence was on his show called Top Tunes and New Talent. And right on the air, he asked me to become a permanent member of his orchestra when I got out of the Navy. Well, at the same time, the Navy offered me a job in Washington, D.C. for the Navy band, which was quite an honor. And I really didn't know quite which direction to go. I could play for the president and White House activities every week, retire when I was 38 years old, or I could become part of one of the top-rated television shows in the country. It was a tough decision, but you know which life I chose. And I made the right decision because I worked for Lawrence Welk for over 25 years. In fact, my work with the Welk family has never stopped. And speaking of, I better get back to work. Take it away, Lawrence.
Here's the very popular Jimmy Roberts singing one of his top requests. Jimmy.
Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue? Have you ever loved someone just as I love you? Can't you see I'm sorry for each mistake I've made? Can't you see I've changed, dear? Can't you see I've paid? Be a little forgiving. Take me back to your heart. How can I go on living now that we're apart? If you knew what I've been through, you would know why I ask you. Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue?
Jimmy, and that fine trombone was played by Kenny Trimble from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Let's watch two very graceful and talented youngsters in action, Cissy King and Bobby Burgess, dancing a quick step. To have this wonderful young dancing couple with us. Here's another performer who means a great deal to our show, Bob Ralston, a very dedicated musician, playing one of his fine piano arrangements.
Thank you.
Every time I hear that song, it reminds me of my wife, Norma. We've been married for 50 years, and I guess she really was meant for me. To celebrate, we sold our house that overlooked the San Fernando Valley, and we moved to the country where we're building a new home. We're both from a small town in Indiana, Portland, Indiana, to be exact, so we feel right at home with our acreage surrounded by wildlife. Wildlife, I should say. A few weeks ago, we had some tall grass cut, and they killed two rattlesnakes in the process. I hope that's the end of that. Our Mediterranean-style home sits on a rocky hill, and the construction crew told us that we have boulders the size of cars, but we were able to take those boulders and build a retainer wall around the property, and it really looks nice. We're in a great location, too. We're close enough to Los Angeles that we can visit our kids and grandchildren when we want. We're just 2 miles from a lake, and I love to fish, and just minutes away from the golf course. There ain't no troubles to pack in my bag.
Let's roll on with the show as we call on our likable gentleman with the flying feet, Arthur Duncan. And here he is entertaining some of his Navy buddies. Great old song from the days of the First World War. Our Philadelphia Colleen is next in our solo spotlight. Natalie Nevins sings a song you folks all remember, Red Sails in the Sunset.
Carry my loved one
you, folks. Now a change in style, and one of the tunes is in my and Florence's new album is titled Alley Cat, one of our real big requests at the Hollywood Palladium. Myron and some of the boys decided to have a little fun with this number, so let's take a stroll down the alley and listen to some swinging cats.
Unique musical instruments we were playing. It's amazing what great music you can get out of a headboard. Well, we weren't really playing those things, but there was a time when I played a kitchen stool, just like this. This is how it came about. One night, Lawrence was at a recording studio and he heard a guy play a kitchen stool. And Lawrence liked the sound that he got. So the next day, he gives me $80, and he told me to go to a furniture store and buy a kitchen stool. So I put these drumsticks in my coat pocket, I walk into this furniture store, and I see some stools in the back of the store. So I go back there, I pull out these sticks, and I start beating on the kitchen stools. Well, here comes the manager. He says, "Hey, what are you doing here?" He says, "You can't beat up on the furniture like that." I said, "Well, I'm trying to find a stool with the right sound." I knew he was just about ready to call the police, but I convinced him that I was for real. And if I can find a kitchen stool with the right sound, I'm gonna play it on the Lawrence Welk Show. I bought two of them. I take them back to the studio. Lawrence picked the one he liked. We put a mic on it, got a sound check, and that night, I played an 8-bar solo on a kitchen stool. Would you believe I played that stool for almost 2 years? I guess it was sort of fun, but I doubt seriously if I would ever receive an Emmy Award playing a kitchen stool, if you know what I mean.
It's Emmy Award time in television. We bring you our own version of this annual ceremony.
Now, the award for the TV show receiving the most cards and letters during the past season. Presenting this award is the lovely singing star, Miss Tanya Falan.
Before presenting the card and letter award, I thought perhaps it would be a kindly gesture on my part to sing for you one of the current hit songs.
Thank you. friend who just happens to call. For the last time, I'll pretend you are mine, my darling. Kiss me goodbye, my darling. Kiss me goodbye.
And now it gives me great pleasure to present the Card and Letter Award to those charming people, the Hollywood Hay Shakers.
Now, I wonder where they got the idea for that kind of a show.
Any resemblance to the Beverly Hillbillies in that number is strictly intentional. I especially like the dancer with the false mustache. Very seldom did we ever steal an idea from another show, but somebody stole an idea of mine one time. I was in New York City, and I went to see the Jackie Gleason show. And after the show, and I even got to meet Jackie Gleason. He was arguing with his producers about the show they had just done that night, and he looked at me and he says, "What did you think of the show, kid?" And I said, "I loved it." He said, "See there, he liked it." But he seemed to appreciate my opinion and told me that he would have his producers watch me on the Lawrence Welk show, and perhaps they might find a way to put me in a show sometime. A few months later, I'm watching the Jackie Gleason show, and all the June Taylor dancers were were tap dancing and pretending to be playing xylophones at the same time. Yeah, I guess his producers did watch me on the Welk show. But I learned then, nothing's sacred in show business. They'll steal your ideas faster than you can say, let's get back to the show.
Lady who combines talent, personality, and especially showmanship. You'll notice that Joanne Castle puts on a show in any kind of surroundings.
How about you?
let's hear the Army story. Larry Hooper gives the Navy some of the facts about life in the Army.
What is this anyway?
The trip? All right, you guys. Now, I know how nice and comfy you've all had it in the Navy, but for the next few days, you're on temporary active duty to the toughest branch of the service, the Army. At ease. This is the Army, Mr. Jones. No private rooms or telephones. You had your breakfast in bed before, but you won't have it there anymore. This is Army, Mr. Green. We like the barracks nice and clean. You had a housemaid to clean your floor, but she won't help you out anymore. Do what the buglers command. They're in the Army and not in a band. This is the Army, Mr. Brown. No more carousing on the town. You had your fun then, but this is war, and you won't stay out late anymore. Do what the buglers command. They're in the Army and not in a band. This is the Army, Mr. Brown. No more carousing on the town. You had your fun then, but this is war, and you won't stay out late anymore. And you won't stay out late anymore. And you won't stay out late anymore. Now the first thing you learn in the Army is how to march. Attention! About face! Double time! March! Halt! I said halt! Hey, come on there, fellas, halt!
I'm afraid the Army's going to have its hands full with that Navy crew. The National Guard is one of the oldest branches of our armed forces, dating back to George Washington's day. This year, for the first time, the Guard has its own official song. We call on the band for this fine new march. I am the Guard.
Getting back to the Armed Forces theme, and there's a pretty funny number about the Navy starring yours truly coming up next. They played a big part in my musical life. They put me through the Navy School of Music in Washington, D.C. But upon graduation, they immediately assigned me to a band in San Diego. So I called my wife and I says, Norma, would you please pack my sea bag right away? We got to be in San Diego in 5 days. I said goodbye to the music school, picked up my wife, we threw her things in a car and headed for San Diego. When we got there, the first day I'm supposed to report to the band, I reached in my sea bag and I got 2 right shoes and no hat.
When I walk, both of my feet pointed in the same direction. Well, I bought a hat for $5, about two sizes too small. And when I reported to the band, I looked like some kind of small town goofus. After wearing two right shoes for 2 weeks, the bandmaster looked at me and he said, "Jack, this is hurting my feet more than it is yours. Here's $15, go buy yourself a pair of shoes." He was a nice guy. As far as the guys in the band were concerned, it took them weeks before they could speak to me without laughing. Ah, yes, I was every inch a sailor.
Jack Emmel, who came to us directly from the Navy, should feel right at home in this next number. We take you aboard a Navy ship where we meet this young sailor.
Hey, Jack, what's with you?
It's time for liberty, pal.
I hear they've got a lot of girls in this port.
Look, you guys go ahead. You know, captain's inspection's tomorrow, and I thought, well, maybe I'd swab up the deck and paint a few bulkheads, tie a knot or two, you know, tidy up the ship, you know.
I'll say one thing for Jack. He's every inch a sailor.
There's never been a sailor who's loved the Navy more. He never thinks of liberty. He never goes ashore. He'd rather paint the ship or swab the deck or tie a knot.
He's got to be the best darn sailor that the Navy's got. Jack is every inch a sailor. 5 and 20 years a sailor. Jack is every inch a sailor. He was born to love the bright blue sea.
Now 'twas 25 or 30 years since Jack first saw the light. He came into this world of woe one dark and stormy night.
He was born aboard his father's ship when he was laying to.
For 25 or 30 years he sailed the sea of blue. Jack is every inch a sailor. 5 and 20 years a sailor. Jack is every inch a sailor. He was born to love the bright blue sea.
Jack is every inch a sailor, huh? Well, you'll be happy to know that Liberty is canceled for the whole crew.
Now maybe you guys can stay here and help me clean up the ship, huh?
I rode by a house with the windows lighted up, looking brighter than a Christmas tree. And I said to myself as I rode by myself, everybody's got a home but me. I rode by a house where a poodle lay asleep in the shadow of a walnut tree. And I said to myself as I rode by myself, everybody's got a home but me. I am free and I'm happy to be free, to be free in the way I want to be. But once in a while, when the road is kind of dark and the end is kind of hard to see, I look up and I cry to a cloud going by. Won't there ever be a home for me somewhere? Everybody
ride the ponies. I am a Yankee Doodle boy. Give my regards to Broadway. Remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that I will soon be there. Whisper of how I'm yearning to mingle with the old time throng. Give my regards to old Broadway and say that I'll be there ere long. You're a grand old flag, you're a high flying flag, and forever in peace may you wave. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the brave. Every heart beats true under red, white, and blue, where there's never a post or brag. But should old acquaintance be forgot, keep your eye on.
Wonderful job on those fine old George M. Cohan songs. And now, friends, our singers salute each branch of our armed forces, starting with the Army.
Over hill, over dale, we have hit the rusty trail. Those days are rolling along. Powder march, line about, can't you hear the captain shout?
Off we go into the wild blue yonder, climbing high into the sun. Here they come, zooming to meet our thunder. Atom boys, give her the gun. Down we dive, spouting our flame from under. Off with one terrible roar.
Thank you, Steve Smith. Next, ladies and gentlemen, the Navy.
Song. We sing the land or sea, through surf and storm and howling gale, high shall our purpose be. Semper Paratus is our guide, our fame and glory too, to fight, to save or fight and die. High Coast Guard, we are for you.
The Marines.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we will fight our country's battles on the land as on the sea. We're to fight for right and freedom and to keep our honor clean. We are proud.
And thank you, friends, for joining us. And to all members of our armed forces, past and present, a very special thank you. Now, until next week, stay happy and keep a song in your heart. Good night.
Well, that's the show, and I'm ready to march on out of here. But I hope you had as much fun as I did reminiscing about my time in the service. And remember to please keep all the men and women in our armed forces in your thoughts and prayers. So long for now.
This program brought to you by the